Welcome to this session on AES Encryption and Decryption. We wish to outline the usage of encrypting and decrypting your own plain text and ciphertext using our Excel workbook. We recommend that you view our AES Algorithm Part 2 128-bit Encryption and Decryption video. The link is given in the description part. We'll use the AES 128 -encrdecr.xlsx workbook. Let's suppose this is our plain text. Okay, how do we encrypt and use this your ciphertext to decrypt? We'll look into that. See, first we must encrypt this using this cipher key. Right. So what I'll do. I'll convert this into the ASCII code, and this ASCII code I will use my plain text. So for this plain text, this is my ciphertext. This is what we have to send it to the other party, counterparty. Now what I'll do, I'll copy this, paste special values. Now this, I am pointing to this. So this is my new ciphertext, and I will revert to my bold ciphertext, bold plain text here, which was. So now you see, this is my plain text and this is my key. So this, the toggle is now set to 0. It is looking into this plain text and then converting it into ciphertext, and this ciphertext is again decrypted back to plain text. See, these two match. Now I use the same key to encrypt a different text. See, I'll set the toggle to 1. See, this is taking from here, and this is my new decrypted text, which I'm converting back into ASCII. You're getting back your plain text. So if you want to send your keys, use the same key. The decrypting party should also use the same key. Okay, one more word of caution. You cannot use this encrypted text, the ciphertext, for 192 and 256. You will have to generate separate keys. Remember, that will be 12 rounds and 14 rounds. So cipher key length is also varying, so it will not work in 192 to 256. You will have to redo it again. So you'll have to encrypt, send it, and then use it for decrypting. And don't forget to set it back to 0, else system will always work for this text and not this. Thank you. Bye.